This video is made possible by Dashlane. Protect your digital identity for free for 30 days by going to dashlane.com/RLL. If you had to draw a map of the world's countries right now, there's just no way that you could possibly do it without offending someone. There's just too many disagreements on borders between countries that will force you into making an awkward choice somewhere while you're drawing. Say that country A believes that the border is further to the right here, but country B believes that the border is actually farther to the left. When you're drawing their border on your map, you have to make a decision on where you draw your border somewhere, and no matter where you do it, you're probably going to make someone very unhappy. But what if you could draw two different maps and show them independently to both country A and country B without them realizing that the other map exists? That way, you can make everybody happy, and that's essentially what Google Maps does across the world. Google Maps is by far the most widely used map in the world. They have over a billion users worldwide located across every country in the world, but not everybody sees the same exact map, and it's very intentionally designed that way. Certain countries have, well, let's just call them disagreements over where their borders extend out to, or where the borders of other countries end at. For an easy way to visualize this inside of Google Maps, you can use the highlighting feature. Select a country that doesn't have controversial borders, like, say, France, and behold, the entire country is highlighted with her borders clearly marked so you can see all of the territory in the world that properly belongs to France. But other countries' borders are a teensy bit more fuzzy than that. And so, there are currently 29 different countries across the world which you aren't able to highlight inside maps, including some pretty big ones, like Pakistan, India, China, Japan, and Russia. All 29 of these countries have the exact same problem which makes them unhighlightable. They have ongoing issues and disagreements about their borders somewhere, which makes highlighting all of their territory controversial to someone, and as you probably know from YouTube, Google hates all things controversial because they impact the company's bottom line, money. If a country the size of China that's already pretty ban-happy as it is with websites got pissed off at maps for marking their borders differently than what the official state policy says they are, well, Google loses out on a customer base of over 1 billion people in an instant. So instead, Google creates different world maps for different users around the world depending on what country's server they're accessing the app from. Take the Crimean Peninsula in Europe, for example. Quick, on three, everybody say what country Crimea belongs to. 1, 2, 3. Ukrusha? This is what most users in the world see when they look at the map of Crimea, just a dotted line marking the peninsula as a disputed territory. But Russian users of maps will instead see a very solid line that clearly marks Crimea as being a part of Russia, while users in Ukraine will see an almost transparent dotted line that suggests Crimea is still a part of Ukraine. This is how Google manages to avoid controversies on maps, by showing three different geopolitical realities to three different groups of countries so that all of them are happy with what they're seeing. But Crimea is far from the only difference that different users in the world will see. Without a doubt, the biggest differences that you'll notice between countries are over in Asia, primarily on the India-Pakistan-China border. Let's start off with this awkward piece of land here, which, depending on who you ask, is either Arunachal Pradesh or South Tibet. If you're looking at maps in literally any country in the world except for either India or China, this is what you'll see here. A dotted line in the north where India asserts the border is, and a dotted line in the south where China asserts the border is. However, if you view maps from an Indian server, this is the changed reality that you'll see. A clearly marked solid border in the north for India without any representation of China's claim at all. But if you view maps from a Chinese server, this is the even weirder reality that you'll see. Not only is the Chinese border clearly marked across China's claim in the south without any representation of India's claim in the north, but all of the Indian-built highways and Indian towns that actually exist and extend beyond China's claimed border just stop abruptly at the border, like they aren't even there, which is a little ominous. But if we look a little bit further over to the west, we can see the weirdest and most awkward conundrum faced by Google Maps. How in the hell do you draw the borders and claims of Jammu and Kashmir without pissing off three countries that all have nuclear weapons and have a combined population equal to almost 40% of everybody on the planet? That's a lot of potential customers that you could lose out on. And here is the problem explained in mildly more depth. Essentially, there's this area of land that's known as Jammu and Kashmir. The Hindu ruler of the state of Jammu and Kashmir decided to join India back in 1947, but Pakistan disagreed based on the fact that the majority of the population in Jammu and Kashmir were and are Muslims. They have since fought multiple wars over the territory, and then China also got involved by claiming these parts of the territory for themselves as extensions of the Chinese provinces of Xinjiang and Tibet. Pakistan has recognized the Chinese claims as legitimate, but continues to claim the rest, while India claims everything, including the Chinese claims. The territory is currently divided in occupation between the three powers, so drawing borders here is probably the most difficult and the most controversial place to draw borders anywhere in the world. And this is how Google manages it inside of maps. When viewed from anywhere outside of India or China, these are the borders that you'll see, which are essentially just a mess of dotted lines representing claims without a clearly defined border in sight. When viewed from an Indian server, however, that's all very different. The entirety of Jammu and Kashmir is drawn to be a part of India without any regard for either the Pakistani or the Chinese claims. While on a Chinese server, the reality is even different still. The Chinese claimed territory is clearly drawn to belong to China with solid borders, while India and Pakistan's claims on each other are still marked by dotted claim lines. The Chinese edition of Google Maps is probably the most different from the main version of maps that the rest of the world sees. You have to remember, though, that pretty much everything owned by Google is banned in China, like YouTube, Android, Gmail, and the Google homepage itself. It's pretty much only Maps that has managed to survive, and it's because Google agrees with official Chinese state policy to censor the app of any border challenges to Beijing. The Chinese edition of Maps even shows Taiwan as a province of China, something that no other edition of Maps does, which all mark Taiwan as an independent entity. The Chinese Google Maps also clearly marks out China's maritime claims in the South China Sea with this heavy dashed line, which again is something that you just won't see on Google Maps while accessing it from any other country. If you want to run a website in China, you have to listen to China's rules. If you want to see what maps look like in other countries, even if you're stuck in China, you'll need a VPN to trick Google into thinking that you're somewhere else. This way, you can see the differences that governments around the world force their citizens to see. And luckily for you, Dashlane Premium has a built-in VPN all ready for you to go. But Dashlane is about a lot more than just that. Dashlane makes your online security easy by generating super safe, complicated passwords for each of your online accounts and storing them all behind just one super secure password that'll be the only one that you ever need to remember, and then autofills those complicated ones that you never have to remember again when you go to log in somewhere. That means that being safe online with Dashlane is easier than just trying to mentally remember all of your different passwords, which we both know is impossible. Best of all, though, is you can start using Dashlane for free by clicking the link in the description or by signing up at dashlane.com/RLL. And if you want to get access to all kinds of other super cool features that keep you safe online, like that VPN I mentioned previously or dark web monitoring, you can upgrade to premium for 10% off by using the code RLL. And as always, thank you for watching.